Welcome. In this video, we are going to see how to create slideshow with images and how to animating text and how to render video in Photoshop. I go to file menu and I choose new. In the new document dialog box, I click film and video category and I select HD TV 1080 pixel and I click create button to create it. Now the document is created. Can't you see the timeline? Go to the workspace switcher and choose essential to motion workspace and click create video timeline to create timeline. The timeline is created. I want to load images to the timeline. So in this track, I click this plus icon. I select the first image and hold shift key and select fifth image and click open. Now the five images are loaded in the timeline and there is no need for layer 0, so I drag to the trash can. Now the layer 0 is deleted. I want to zoom in the timeline little bit, so I drag the slider. Now you can see the images clearly. I select this first image. In order to set the motion, I click this little arrow key. Currently the motion is set to no motion. I click this and I select pan and zoom. Here you can set how much degree you want to pan. I want to set 92. In the zoom option, I select zoom in and I leave it resize to fill canvas. I want to see the preview. You can see the nice animation is created. In the same way, I want to apply it to the second image. Click this motion settings and I switch to rotate the image. The rotation is clockwise. In the same way, I leave it resize to fill canvas. Check the preview. Nice rotation is applied here. In the same way, I select the third image. Here I want to apply only zoom and the zoom option is currently set to zoom in and I check resize to fill canvas and I want to see the preview. You can see. Okay, I come to fourth image. In the same way, I want to set motion to rotate and zoom. In the rotate option, I choose counterclockwise. In the zoom option, I choose zoom out. I check it. Okay. In the fifth image, click here. I want to set zoom and I select zoom out here. Okay, the zoom out effect is applied. I want to see the preview from the beginning, so I drag the playhead and play it. Okay, I am satisfied with this animation and I want to add music to this timeline. I click this add media button and I select electronic MP3 file and I click open. Now you can see the audio is loaded here and I play it again. Okay, I want to cut this extra audio. So I positioned the playhead in the last frame and I click this scissor icon. A trimming is applied here and I select this second portion and press delete key to delete it. Now the audio is trimmed. I want to save it, So I go to file menu and I choose save and I select save on your computer. I named it to slideshow and I click OK and I click save button and I click OK. Now the document is renamed as slideshow. In order to make much smoother animation, I want to apply transition effect between the clips. Now I click this transition button and I select crash fade effects and drag between those clips. You can see a black square box is appeared. I release the mouse button, the effect is applied. I want to check the preview. Now a smoother animation is created. Now I come to the next image. You can see a yellow flower. So I select the transition fade with color and I want to set the color to yellow and I click OK and drag the effect to this place and I want to check the preview. Okay, nice to see. I go to the next image. I drag the playhead. Here I want to drag fade with white. You can see the transition. It is perfect. In the last clip, I want to set crossfade again. You can change the duration of the transition effect. Right click on it. With the help of the slider, you can increase or decrease the duration, or you can delete the transition effect. Okay. Again, I want to trim the audio clip. It's done. Now the time to animating the text. In the keyboard, I press OM key. Now the playhead moved to the first frame. In the video group on track, I press the down arrow and I choose new video group. You can see a new video group is created above the video group 1. I select text tool in the toolbar and I click middle of the image and type it flower and I select all the text. I want to change the color. I select this color and click OK and click the check mark. I want to apply some style effects. So I go to layers panel and double click on the text layer. Now the layer style window is opened. I select the stroke option. You can see a nice stroke effect is applied with the white color and the size is 5 pixel and position is outside. Blend mode is normal and opacity is 100%. And I click OK. And I press V key in the keyboard and I move it down. And I press Ctrl T in the keyboard and I scale it down the text and I click OK. I positioned the text in the lower left corner. Now I want to apply entering text effect. So I go to video group 2 and I press this little arrow. You can see transformation, opacity, style and text warp animation option here. We have to set the keyframe for animation. I move the playhead to this position. We can record the current position of the text with the help of transformation keyframe. Now you can see a keyframe is added. The keyframe is recorded the current position of the text. Also, I want to apply opacity keyframe. So I click this opacity stopwatch. Now, the keyframe is recorded the current obesity. The current obesity is 100%. You can see in the layers panel. And I move the playhead to the beginning. Now, we have to record various position and the obesity of the text. So, I press the keyframe button, not the stopwatch. If you click the stopwatch, all the keyframes are deleted. So, be careful. Now, I add another obesity keyframe. Whenever you make any changes, the keyframe is recorded the changes. Shift key in the keyboard and move the text outside of the window. Now, the current position and the obesity is recorded. Now, I go to layers panel and I decrease the opacity to 50%. Now, I play the preview. You can see a nice entering text effect is applied. I shrink it down little bit. Now, I finished the slideshow. I want to render the video. I click this retire arrow below the timeline. Now, I get render video settings. In the location section, you can see the name of the video. The current name is our document name, slideshow. You can select the destination you want to save. The media encoder is set to Adobe Media Encoder. And you can set the format, QuickTime or DPX. Now, I choose H.264 because H.264 have variety of formats. In the preset option, you can get variety of formats. I choose YouTube HD 720 pixel. The size also set to preset size. Frame rate set to the document frame rate. In the aspect ratio option, you can set NTSC widescreen, PAL, and you can get anamorphic and HD anamorphic 1080 pixel document 1.0 and select the range of frames. Now I select all the frames because I want to render whole video. If you want to render a portion of the video, you can set the starting frame and the end of the frame. In the 3D quality, I set interactive OpenGL. If I click the render button, I can render out the video. Click it. Now you can see the video is rendering. Now you can see our video is playing. Thank you for watching. I will meet you the next lesson.